I always talk about how there's truth in movies, comedy, TV shows, and even when it comes to cartoons such as The Simpsons and lies in the news. This is all about Freemasonry, this world of duality. Let's take a listen to this scene here from The Simpsons.
They're all covered with filthy germs, aren't they, Smithers?
Why, what do you mean, sir?
Freemasons run the country!
Not only this country, but the entire world. People need to understand, it's not a question if someone's a Mason. In Hollywood, the music industry, all these people on the very top of this world, they're all Masons. Everybody underneath that are non-Masons, we just get the crumbs in this world. Taking a look at Sylvester Stallone, Matt Groening, the creator of The Simpsons, and John Carpenter of They Live, Halloween, and so many other movies. These are all Freemasons, once again. So, when you look at any directors, writers, or producers in Hollywood, you know there are Masons. It's not a question if. It's only Masons to make it to the top of this world. Now, all the connections when it comes to Matt Groening, and you see here, they're all doing the Eye of Illumination because they're all part of this exclusive club, you know, better known in the mainstream as the Illuminati, which is actually Freemasonry. Illuminati is just a cover for Freemasonry. That's what it's all about. Basically, Club 33, the highest degree in the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry. Taking a look at all the connections, again, when it comes to Matt Groening, for anybody that doubts he's a Freemason, like everybody else in Hollywood, and again, everybody else that makes it top of this world. Take a look here. Again, when you take a look at The Simpsons, everybody's seen this. Very famous with Bart Simpson holding the money. You see the magazine held by Lisa. It's New York, you see the 9 and the 11, of course. As I mentioned many times, the towers came down after 33 years. Construction first started in 1968, the towers, of course, came down in 2001. This was nothing more than a Freemasonic ritual. Now, more connections made here with the Simpsons. You have the Simpson family, you know, parking right in front of a 33-cent store. Just take a look at the name Simpson. Again, these people, they work on the number systems. Not only numbers, colors, dates, signs, and symbols. This is what Masonry is all about. This is their own language of communication. It's not for the masses to understand or comprehend, or those that watch this video and say, you know, conspiracy theorists, this and that. You people don't understand. You have been completely manipulated and mind-controlled by those that own and control TV. Again, they don't just devise these names out of thin air. Now, just like here, like I pointed out, with the Twin Towers, each Twin Tower was exactly 110 stories each. Why is that? You have a man named David Rockefeller behind the Twin Towers. Okay, Rockefeller just happens to be 110 in numerology. Take away the zero, and you get 11 as in the Twin Towers as well. These people are occultists. If you don't understand the occult, you don't understand Freemasonry, this is all going to go over your head. And of course, you're never going to hear about this stuff on TV. These are the same people that own and control all of TV. Okay, but they'll give you truth, which seems ridiculous to most in these cartoons, TV shows, and again, comedy. This is the world of opposites, of duality, where nothing is as it appears. Another example with mockery when it comes to The Simpsons. Take a look at this episode. You see these two dancing, and right behind them, you see this tower on fire, of course, representing 9/11. This was dated back in 1997, around that time frame. Now, more connections made here. These so-called elite Freemasons behind the scenes, again, doing things in opposites. This is the satanic way. When you see the clock here, you see the 9/11 upside down. Again, this is how they do it. Now, again, people like Matt Groening are in the know. They know the scripted reality we're living in. They're part of it, creating it, which, you know, Hollywood and TV shows are nothing more than social programming and mockery as well. When you see this episode of The Simpsons, again, back to 1997, and they have the Ebola virus. Just taking a look here, as I've shown before, all four supposed American victims, 33 years old. Now, what are the chances of this? This was nothing more than a Freemasonic hoax. Now, more connections made in understanding just simple concepts, you know, these so-called enlightened ones are all about. When you see these characters with only four fingers on their hands, they can easily have them, you know, with five fingers on each hand. Why is this? It just so happens Matt Groening in Chaldean numerology is 44. So you understand the concept. Everything they do, there is a reason. It's not pulled out of thin air. Just take a look at Bart Simpson here. Normally, he wears the red and blue. This is all about, again, masonry. You get the Blue Lodge. You also have here the Queen of England and the nurse wearing the red and blue. And you see the Masonic symbols. You see the pentagram as well. So again, understand, there is a reason for everything. They don't devise these concepts out of thin air. Now, let's take a look at this one episode. For example, talking about concepts where they don't just pull things out of thin air. You see this one episode, Orange is the New Yellow, because orange is all about Freemasonry, the only color in numerology that is 33. So again, if you don't understand Freemasonry, you see a tie like this, just go right over your head. Just like a comedian telling you a joke when you don't understand what he's saying. Okay, now let's take a look here. All about the occult. Again, annual meeting, International Brotherhood of Evil. And you have the lightning bolt and you have the skull. Of course, as I mentioned before, lightning is a representation of Satan, where it states in the Bible, Luke chapter 10, verses 18, where Jesus beheld Satan falling from heaven as lightning. Just like the founder of the Satanic Church, Anton LaVey, with the lightning bolt within the upside-down Satanic pentagram. Again, they're all about signs and symbols with these Satanists, with these occultists. Let's take a look at this other episode here from The Simpsons with the pentagram as well. More examples. You have the right side pentagram. Now, again, hidden symbols in plain sight with the Masonic square and compass. Take a look here again. I'm going to get to this more with the skull. It's all about skull and bones, but let's take a look here. More signs and symbols from The Simpsons. And you get the Masonic, again, square and compass, the all-seeing eye within the pyramid. Again, all about masonry, right in plain sight. So people that want to deny that Matt Groening is part of this club of Freemasons, of course, if you don't know about the occult, it's going to brush off as you believe, oh, if this was true, the news would tell us so. Again, you have no concept and understanding of who those behind the scenes that control it all, that are all Masons working together. And as I showed this image earlier, with the reference to the skull, it's all about skull and bones. And let's look at this episode of The Simpsons. Again, a reference to skull and bones of Yale. Take a listen.
And he's the proud bearing and glossy fur coat of a Yale man. Hello, little fella. Smith, I believe this dome was in skull and bones.
Again, if you don't understand Freemasonry about the occult, you'll not understand, you'll not catch what he's saying. Basically, they're all about, again, sign symbols, also these Masonic handshakes. And this dog supposedly is doing some type of Masonic handshake, a reference to skull and bones. Again, an inside joke, only the occultist will understand it. As you see here, George Bush, and you see the skull and bone symbolism. Let's take a look here. I found pretty interesting, again, when it comes to Mr. Burns, as you see here. I'll get into him in a little bit as far as who this represents. First off, the concept of Mr. Burns. Let's take a look here. And you'll see here, again, the 33. Once you understand Masonry, once you understand the occult, you understand what's taking place in this world. It's very simple once you understand what's taking place. Now, before Matt Groening even started with The Simpsons, let's take a look here what he was a part of, what he started, this comic called How to Go to Hell. Way back to 1977. Again, these people are basically, Freemasons are nothing more than Satanists in disguise. So take a look here from Fox, and I want to touch upon Fox with this preview. I'm going to show it right now. Actually, I kind of skipped ahead here, but you see The Simpsons on Fox. Now understand the occult and the Matrix and what's taking place here. You understand, again, the occult, you understand what's taking place. You have Fox in Pythagorean numerology, how it's all lined up. You get, again, 666 when it comes to Fox. This is why you have 20th Century Fox. This is why you have Fox News. And, of course, the Fox Channel itself. Fox Film. The list goes on and on. Now, let's take a look here at this preview. Play right here first. I found this pretty interesting. A reference to breaking through the dome with Homer Simpson. Take a look here.
Tonight, Homer discovers there's a secret vault.
I saw weird, twisted, eerie, godless, evil stuff, and I want in.
On a brand new Simpsons Tonight.
There you go. It's all about masonry, all about partaking in evil. And you see the blindfold. This is all about masonry once again. Taking a look at this Masonic ritual taking place, and you see the blindfold. Again, it's all about masonry, signs and symbols. Again, what they're all about. Now, let's take a look here, this one episode, as you see these people raptured away to heaven. Let's see what's taking place here with the Simpson family. Rapture away to heaven. Lisa's being pulled up. One thing I find interesting, if you're positive at the right spot, you back up just a tiny bit, and he does the devil horns right before sending down to hell. Trying to make hell sound like not such a bad thing. And again, the reference to falling through the firmament, the dome, as I've shown before, I'll play it once again. With this scene here, again, just more mockery.
There's steroids, Santa Claus, kicks and deals. It's a long fly ball going back, back. And the ball shatters the sky, bringing the ocean itself down into the...
Again, just a mockery of the Bible where it mentions God's firmament. This is what it's about. Again, people watch this. Millions and millions of people worldwide will watch this and have no understanding, no concept what this is all about. And again, this image with the so-called enlightened ones. And I'll play... this clip as well, talking about enlightened ones, the same entire concept like I mentioned earlier, truth in movies and lies in the news. Take a listen to what Mel Gibson says here, again, in this movie titled Conspiracy Theory.
Bush knew what he was saying when he said New World Order. Remember those three little words, New World Order? Well, he was a 33rd degree Mason, you know, and his ex-director of the CIA.
George Bush was a 33rd degree Freemason. Again, this is how they do it. They love to mock. Again, the world of opposites and duality, where nothing is as it seems. Now, again, for those that don't understand the whole entire concept of Freemasonry, I'll play a previous video showing all the connections with the 33 when it comes to such as Time Warner and CNN, the police departments, and so on. So people understand this whole scope, the entire big picture, not just when it comes to the Simpsons, the whole basic world system, which is run by Freemasons from behind the scenes. The connection with Alex Jones, nothing more than a made-up character, and Glenn Beck. Let's take a look at this interesting connection. Alex Jones, again, this made-up character. Why do they give him the name Alex Jones? You just so happen to get a 33. Now, Glenn Beck, this Time magazine cover. And how people can't see, this is just an actor. You have the occult with Madman. I mean, everything, like I said, is devised for a reason. They don't just come up with these concepts for this title of Time magazine with Madman for no reason at all. Turn it sideways. And you get the MM for 33. Just like Marty McFly, Mad Max, Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Marilyn Manson, Marilyn Monroe, Michael Myers, the list goes on and on and on. All these fictitious names in Hollywood are basically made up to get that 33 with the MM. And now the connection again with Alex Jones. Take a look at this. Chaldean numerology. Glenn Beck. Just so happens to be 33 as well. So, we have these two so-called truth speakers from InfoWars, which is Time Warner, one with Fox News, the liberal station, CNN, and the conservative station with Fox News, and you get the 233. So, what does this all mean? When it all comes down to it, everything is synchronized to get that number 33 with Freemasonry. Find it pretty amazing what's taking place. People, you know, they'll watch these two speak for years and years, and they'll fall for the deception, fall for the half-truths at best, and not understand what's taking place here in this deception. Now, again, I'll play my previous video making the connection again with the world deceived in 5 minutes. With all the videos I make about the hoaxes and psyops, with so many people coming to my channel saying, not everything's a hoax, they don't understand what's taking place, I'm going to break this down quickly and make all the connections necessary so people that are blind to what's taking place, they can see, even they can see the obvious. Going back in time, well before any of us in this world were around, just take a look at George Washington, at this bust in Washington, D.C. Here is another one here. A little bit of a closer look. States here, George Washington, Freemason, and first president in that order. Okay? You're not going to hear about this. In elementary school, middle school, high school, college, university. And why not? You need to ask yourself, why not? Why don't they tell us that George Washington was a Freemason? Why don't they tell us about Freemasonry in the school system? Because these are the ones behind the scenes that control it all. Taking a look at these images, you have Harry Truman wearing the Masonic fez that says Arafat on it. Okay. See Harry Truman again, fellow Freemasons. He's wearing the Masonic apron. Okay, you see it right there? Now, taking a look at Richard Nixon. You see the Masonic handshake. All working together, these world leaders, all on the same page. Gerald Ford, the Masonic fez. Okay? Now take a look here at George Bush with Skull and Bones. Now the connection, the pecking order from the top to the bottom. Let's take a look here at the police department. Taking a look at this Masonic police pin. The name police itself and the G is both equal 33. People need to understand, they don't devise these names out of thin air. It's always a reason for everything. Take a look here. See, police is 33 in numerology. Also, with the G, a very clever way how they devise the G. It comes to 33, A through Z, 26, skip over, and you get the G for 33. So understand, who controls the police department? These were established by the Freemasons. It's owned and controlled by the Masons. It's very easy to see, when you have eyes to see, and you see the gloves, the Masonic gloves, see the checkerboard, just like the Masonic Lodge. It's very easy, once you put all the pieces together, to see what's taking place. Now, make it the connection from these so-called leaders, such as George Bush here, again to the police department, now to the actors involved in the world stage, such as Robbie Parker and Emily Parker, his supposed daughter, the name Robbie Parker. Robbie is 33. So is Parker. Parker is 33. So, you see everybody involved in this matrix, and you'll see that 33. Just like I've shown here before as well. Okay, Robbie and Parker, both 33. Just like the Ebola hoax. All these supposed American victims, 33 years old. Now, if you think this is a coincidence, then you are absolutely not interested in the truth. You're just interested in preserving the lie system that you've been born into. And not interested in seeking truth. And this is why they're called the enlightened ones. They're the ones with all the knowledge. Everybody below is kept ignorant. Even those in the school system, they're simply paid to teach out of the textbooks. They cannot deviate. If they deviate, they're basically out of a job. So understand, you know, generation after generation after generation have been brainwashed to the entire exact same system of lies and deception. And they don't even know it. Again, they're just teaching what they're told to teach. Now, taking a look here, when it comes to the media, just one last connection. Like I showed before with CNN. Look at this logo. Everything they do, there is a reason. As I showed here, turn this logo sideways, and you get the 233s. And if you think that's just a coincidence, as I showed before, CNN is located on the 33rd parallel. So, with this video, you can see the chain of command when it takes place with all the hoaxes, all the psyops. And again, most people are in denial. They don't want to believe this is true. But this is undeniable. Who's behind it all? Once people are down a path of lies, it's very hard to turn around, especially when you spend tens of thousands of dollars on your education and everything you've been told is nothing but a lie. The truth pill is a very hard one to swallow. Again, very few want to admit they've been lied to their entire lives. It's a sad truth. Again, ego and pride in what they believe is truth is preventing them from seeing what's taking place in the absolute truth of this matrix. Mason, you know, in Hollywood, the music industry, all these people on the very top of this world, they're all Masons. Everybody underneath that are non-Masons, we just get the crumbs in this world. Taking a look at Sylvester Stallone, Matt Groening, the creator of The Simpsons, and John Carpenter of They Live, Halloween, and so many other movies. These are all Freemasons, once again. So, when you look at any directors, writers, or producers in Hollywood, you know there are Masons. It's not a question if. It's only Masons making the top of this world. Well, take a look here. Again, when you take a look at The Simpsons, everybody's seen this. Very famous with Bart Simpson holding the money. You see the magazine held by Lisa. It's New York. You see the 9 and the 11, of course. As I mentioned many times, the towers came down after 33 years. Construction first started in 1968. The towers, of course, came down in 2001. This is nothing more than a Freemasonic ritual. Now, more connections made here with the Simpsons. You have the Simpson family, you know, parking right in front of a 33-cent store. Just take a look at the name Simpson. Again, these people, they work on the number systems. Not only numbers, colors, dates, signs, and symbols. This is what Masonry is all about. This is their own language of communication. It's not for the masses to understand or comprehend. For those that watch this video and say, you know, conspiracy theorists, this and that. You people don't understand. You have been completely manipulated and mind-controlled by those that own and control TV. Again, they don't just devise these names out of thin air. Now, just like here, like I pointed out with the twin, I always talk about how there's truth in movies, comedy, TV shows, and even when it comes to cartoons such as The Simpsons and lies in the news. This is all about Freemasonry, this world of duality. Let's take a listen to this scene here from The Simpsons.
They're all covered with filthy germs, aren't they, Smithers?
Why, what do you mean, sir?
Freemasons run the country!
Not only this country, but the entire world. People need to understand. It's not a question if someone's a... Now, all the connections when it comes to Matt Groening, and you see here, they're all doing the Eye of Illumination because they're all part of this exclusive club, you know, better known in the mainstream as the Illuminati, which is actually Freemasonry. Illuminati is just a cover for Freemasonry. That's what it's all about. Basically, Club 33, the highest degree in the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry. Taking a look at all the connections, again, when it comes to Matt Groening, for anybody that doubts he's a Freemason, like everybody else in Hollywood, and again, everybody else that makes the top of this world.